Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com and this is part 10 of my course, The Practical Guide to Mac Security. This course is completely free thanks to my great Patreon supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon to find out how you could join us. So now we get to a lesson that it really is at the heart of this course. It's how to keep your Mac safe from malware. In the last lesson, I mentioned that you don't need antivirus software, but you do need to take care and follow some rules. And these are those rules. So whether you call it malware, whether you call them viruses, or just something that gets on your computer that you don't want there that's going to compromise your security, here's how you prevent that from happening. The first rule is keep your Mac up to date. This should be a fairly simple one. macOS auto updates, just make sure that's turned on. Make sure that you are using the latest version of macOS that your Mac allows. If you have an older Mac, you may not be able to use the absolute latest one, but keep it as up to date as possible. In addition to major updates like Mojave Catalina and all the way up to Monterey, you also have minor updates, things like 11.1, 11.2, that kind of thing. And there are even smaller updates, security updates in that. Make sure you have all of that turned on so that you have the latest operating system, and that's true for all your Apple devices. In addition, also make sure that your software is up to date. Using out-of-date software could lead to vulnerabilities. So by software, I mean mostly your apps. And you may think that, well, this app doesn't do anything that could possibly be a problem with security. Well, that's not true. Apps are built on top of software libraries. Software libraries contain lots and lots of code. They regularly receive updates to those libraries, and the apps you use then use those libraries. So even a minor update to an app could, deep down there, have some sort of security fix for opening a certain type of file or accessing something online. So you want to make sure all of your apps as well as your operating system is up to date, and anything else that is software on your Mac. So extensions for Safari, extensions for the system, any kind of plugins for any software you've got, anything, make sure it's always kept up to date. To keep your Mac up to date, all you need to do is in the Apple menu go to System Preferences, and from there look for Software Update. This will check for an update automatically, and make sure you have Automatically Keep My Mac Up to Date here. Under Advanced, you should have all of these checked. Check for updates, down new updates when available, install macOS updates, install app updates from the App Store, and install system data files and security updates. Very important. So if you have all of those checked, your Mac will automatically be kept up to date. In the App Store, when you're in here, you can go to Updates, and it will show you if there are any app updates. But if you have it set to automatic, then you should rarely ever see anything in here unless there's been a very recent update. The second rule is only download from sites you trust. Now, if you only use the Mac App Store, then you're set. That is a site you should trust. Apple has security protocols in place. Developers have to register their software. There are checks made. And if there's any problem, Apple can take action against the developer or the software. And it's a very safe place to download software. However, if you need to download software from outside the Mac App Store, then you should research the apps thoroughly. So if it's an app you want to add, first, of course, ask yourself if you really need it, whether it's worth a small security risk to get it. Can you do without it? Can you find something in the Mac App Store that can do that instead? Make sure that the app is considered to be safe. So you could just do searches and read various things that people write on different forums. A search will pretty quickly turn up if there is a problem and that app should be avoided. If you are in doubt, you can always ask an expert. And if you're still in doubt, then you should probably go with not installing the software if at all possible. And keep in mind, when I say download from sites you trust, I do mean sites, literally. So it's not the app so much as the site. For example, there might be an app out there, like say Adobe Photoshop. And Adobe Photoshop's been around for a long time. It's certainly is from a trusted company and it's a trusted app and should be no problem having that on your Mac. However, if you go and download Adobe Photoshop from a site that is not Adobe, then you could run into trouble. It could say that it's Adobe Photoshop, and maybe it actually is a version of Adobe Photoshop, but it comes with some malware with it. So it's the site or service that you're downloading from that you need to trust more than the app itself. There are sites out there that say that they are repositories for software and you can download software from them. Never use those. Go to the developer or publisher's website to download software. Never go to a third party place. Only the official site, the official location for that software is where you should download it. And the third rule is simply stay informed. Any major problem that's going to come up, any security threat to Mac users will certainly be reported heavily in the news. So just keep up to date, follow MacMost. There are other news sites like Mac Rumors. Whatever one you want to choose, most Mac news sites and technology sites would report on a problem. You don't have to follow every day, but it's good to be up to date and not be totally in the dark and have no idea what's going on if a major problem were to occur. So there are the three rules. Just remember these, practice these, and your Mac will stay malware free.
If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.